Hi everyone, today I'll introduce you to LookdevX, which is a new material authoring plugin for Maya. In this tutorial, I'll cover the basics of LookdevX. I'll start with the structure of a USD stage, which is required for the operation of LookdevX, and then I'll demonstrate step by step how to assign and edit materials using LookdevX. Without further ado, let's jump right in. USD stands for Universal Scene Description. It's a framework developed by Pixar Animation Studios to increase pipeline efficiency. If you're new to USD, we have both Maya USD and Bifrost USD tutorials that you can watch. I've included the links in the description. Here's a diagram showing the structure of a typical USD stage. We see that there's a root layer and two sublayers, one for storing the geometries and one for storing the materials. This structure enables different artists to work together without interfering with each other or accidentally overwriting others' work. Usually, artists responsible for modeling and animation create the root layer and the geometry sublayer, and texture artists create the material sublayer. When a USD stage is saved, every layer is saved as a .usd file. This allows different artists to work simultaneously without changing each other's file. As we just learned, for texture artists, the material sublayer is where they create and modify materials, and it should be set as the target layer when working with LookdevX. In the first example, I'll show you how to create this simple USD stage with a root layer and two sublayers. The geometry sublayer will contain a sphere and a cube, and the material sublayer will have two surface materials. And I'll show you how to assign materials to the geometries. So let's see how to do it in Maya. To work with LookdevX, you need both the USD layer editor and the LookdevX graph editor. You can find both in the menu bar under Windows. To create a new USD stage, go to the USD layer editor, click Create, and select Stage with New Layer. We see here it has created an anonymous layer, which is the root layer of this USD stage. If you double-click on it, it opens a window where you can rename and save this layer. I'm going to name it demo.usd. Now let's create two sublayers, one for the geometry and the other one for the materials. To create a new sublayer, just right-click on the root layer and select Add Sublayer. Double-click and let's name it demogeo.usd. And repeat this operation to create the sublayer for storing the materials. I'm going to name this one demomtl.usd. Right now, both the geometry and material layers are empty. Let's first create some geometries on the geometry layer. To work on the specific layer, we need to target that layer by clicking the circle in front of the layer name. When we see this blue target sign, it means that this layer is targeted, and whatever we're gonna create will be written onto this layer. Now with the demo geo layer set as the target layer, we're ready to create the geometries. Go to the outliner, expand the stage here, right-click on Stage Shape. Under Add New Prim, we see there are a few options that we can choose from. If we select, say, Sphere, it creates a sphere prim. Another way of creating a geometry in USD is to create a regular Maya geometry and then duplicate it as USD data. For example, you can first create a sphere in Maya, then right-click on it in the outliner, under Duplicate as USD Data, select Stage Shape 1, which is the USD stage that we've just created. I'm going to hide the original Maya geometry, and now we see that we have this sphere in our USD stage. Similarly, we can create a cube and duplicate it as USD data. Now we have both a sphere and a cube on the demo geo layer. press Ctrl S to save the stage. Now let's move on to the materials. Before we create anything, we should change the target layer to the material sublayer, demo MTL. It's good practice for texture artists to always target the material sublayer before creating or editing any material. To assign material to a geometry, go to the outliner, right-click at the geometry, under Assign New Material, there are three options, Arnold, MaterialX, and USD. I'll use MaterialX as an example in this tutorial. I'm going to select MaterialX, Standard Surface. This operation creates a new surface contained in the material prim, and assigns it to the geometry we selected. We can see it here in the outliner that it has created a standard surface under the material prim. This MTL prim acts as a container for surface materials. Let's repeat this operation to create another standard surface. You may wonder why there are two standard surface icons here for every surface we created. I'm going to explain it in a moment. To edit a surface in LookdevX, right-click and select Show in LookdevX. And we see the standard surface node in the LookdevX graph editor. This is a USD material compound, which acts as a container for the material graph. You can double-click on it to go inside the compound. And here we see the MaterialX standard surface shader, which can be used to create any type of material. In the parameters panel, we have all the parameters of this shader that we can adjust. And this surface shader node is what this icon refers to. That's why it's one level below the first standard surface icon, which refers to the compound. If I rename this shader node to Surface Shader 1, you'll see more clearly in the outliner that we have this shader node inside the USD material compound. Now let's adjust some of the parameters of the shader. You can change the color, the reflection, transparency, add a soft surface, add a sheen, etc. Let's also open the second surface that we created in LookdevX. And adjust some of the parameters. And I'm going to rename the shader node Surface Shader 2. Now we have both materials created and adjusted. In addition to assigning new material, we can also assign existing material to a geometry. For example, we can right-click at the sphere, go to Assign Existing Material, and here we see the two surfaces that we just created. If we select the second surface, this orange material will be assigned to the sphere. And similarly, we can assign the yellow material to the cube. To get a rendered view, let's add a light, such as a sky dome light. And click this Arnold button. Now we have completed this simple USD stage. Let's save the USD files and take a look at each layer in the script editor. In the root layer, we see that it contains two sublayers, Demo MTL and Demo Geo. On the Demo Geo sublayer, we have the mesh sphere and the mesh cube with their geometric data. On the Demo MTL sublayer, we have the two standard surfaces, as well as the material binding relationships that tell which material is bound to which geometry. That's the basics of material assignment in the USD stage. Now I'm going to use this kiss shoe as an example to review the workflow that we just learned. Let's hide this stage and create a new stage for the shoe. I'm going to name it shoe.usd. This diagram shows the two sublayers that I'm going to create. For the geometry sublayer, I'll use an existing USD file that contains these four components of the shoe. And for the material sublayer, I'll create five different materials that I can choose from for texturing the shoe. So let's start with the geometry sublayer. To create the sublayer with an existing USD file, select Load Sublayers and choose the file that you want to use. Now we see the shoe, which at this moment doesn't have any material assigned to it. Let's take a look at the USD stage in the outliner. Here's the parent prim on the shoe GL sublayer that we just loaded. Within this parent prim, there are four mesh prims, each being a component of this shoe. For the materials, I'm going to create another sublayer and name it shoeMTL.usd. In the previous example, we created the materials by right-clicking at the geometry and select Assign New Material. And that operation did both the creation and assignment of the material. We can also create materials without assigning them, and the assignment can happen later. Here's how to do it. First of all, make sure that the material sublayer is targeted. Then go to the outliner, right-click at Stage Shape 2, under Add New Prim, select Scope, and rename it MTL. Scope is the simplest prim type. It acts as a container. It's useful when creating a structure that contains objects that don't need to be transformed, such as materials. To add material to this prim, right-click, go to Add New Material. As before, I'll use MaterialX as an example. Select Standard Surface. To add more materials, I'm going to repeat this operation a few times. Now I've created four standard surfaces. Let's open them in a new graph. Right-click under Show in LookdevX, select New Tab. For the first surface, I'm going to give it a blue color and rename the shader to blue. Let's try assigning this material to the front part of the shoe. As we learned in the previous example, we can assign an existing material by right-clicking at the geometry and select Assign Existing Material. Let's choose Standard Surface 1, which is the blue surface. Now we see that the front part of the shoe has the blue surface assigned to it. And this is the rendered view. I'm going to do the same for the other surfaces. Open them in the graph editor. Adjusting the colors. And rename them based on the colors. For every surface, I'll also rename the compound that contains the shader so that when we assign materials, it's easier to tell which is which. Now we have four surfaces with different colors. Let's assign materials to the other parts of the shoe. And now we have a completed scene. You can easily change the color of any part of the shoe by assigning a different material. In addition to solid colors, we can also create an image texture. To do that, I'm going to create another standard surface. Open it in LookdevX. I'm going to rename this material Standard Surface Floral and rename the shader Floral. To create an image texture, we can use the node Tiled Image Color for the base color of the shader. In the tab menu, there's a ND Tiled Image Color 3 and a ND Tiled Image Color 4. Here, ND means it's a node for Material X. And in this case, what we need is the RGB values of the colors. So we choose ND Tiled Image Color 3. In the parameters panel, we can load an image file. I'm going to select this floral pattern, which I downloaded from vectz.com. Connect the output of the tiled image node to the port base color of the shader node. Let's assign this floral surface to the shoe. Turn on the texture view, and we see the floral pattern. We can adjust the UV scale in the parameters panel. Since the original image is a square, you can hold Shift to select both the U and V values and adjust them at the same time. Let's assign this material to the other parts of the shoe as well. And here's a rendered view. That's it for today. To recap, we learned the basic structure of a USD stage, how to assign materials, and how to adjust them in LookdevX. We'll have more LookdevX tutorials coming soon. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.